Fellow agents, I'm Connor McIver. Anyway, I wanted to reach out to my fellow real estate agents. They've been asking me to do a recording about how to keep yourself safe from getting scammed with people calling you and saying, hey, we're the next best thing in advertising. Use us, pay us this amount of money, and we'll be able to make sure that you get all the business in the world. So I'm going to give you three things to think about whenever you get these phone calls. Now, of course, we don't have a lot of time. I know a lot of us are very busy, but occasionally you're going to get that phone call, you're going to get that email, or you're going to get that pitch in your office by somebody, some company, some person, and they're going to say, hey, you know, we're going to be able to take you to the next level, Mr. and Mrs. Agent. You're going to be so amazingly popular, you're not going to believe it. So one of the things that I would do, and I'll give you an example. I had a call a few days ago that's kind of preempted this, also some of you asking for me to do it. And the phone call was basically a gentleman who was the lead into trying to offer me a service. And what basically he said was, you know, we're going to be able to place you on page one on Google, which is where you need to be. And we're going to be able to do this for $49.99 a month. We're going to be able to have IDX, you know, those listings that are on Zillow and Realtor.com, as if, you know, I don't understand, but, and yeah, I know you do too. He said, those are going to be on your website. I said, oh, really? He said, yes. He said, as a matter of fact, for every single listing on the market, and in Southern California, if you're listening to this from here, we're around 11 grand currently, and we're February 1st, 2018. So it's about 11,000 listings. We're going to build separate pages for those. Oh, my God. So I said, this is something like Diverse Solutions offers that IDX Press option within their WordPress sites or the blog, right? He said, well, I don't know anything about that. I said, okay, well, and what else? He said, well, not only that, but the only way you're going to get to be on page one is by content. I said, oh, okay, so you're going to help me with the content. He said, well, that's what the site does. It basically generates automatic content for every single listing that's posted out there. You're going to be the one that's going to be behind it. So while the consumer's searching, they're going to be searching for real estate in Santa Clarita, and they're going to be able to find you. I said, really? So you're going to have me page one for $50 a month for real estate, the keywords, real estate in Santa Clarita, the keyword phrase. So right after that moment, he got confused. He wasn't exactly sure what I was asking. But you could tell he had heard something. So he said immediately, you know what? I'm really kind of just the contact person to see if people are interested with this fantastic deal. But the person that you need to talk to is going to be the programmer, the tech side. They'll be able to share with you exactly how this works. So that's red flag number three or number four throughout this entire conversation. So let me give you these three things to ask for. Now, here's the red flag, okay? The only way you're going to get to page one organic and beat out Zillow and Trulia and Realtor.com, number one, you can pay for placement, pay-per-click, or if you do have lots of content and you are out there and people are sharing you, you're engaging with other agents. And that means engaging means you write this article. Like, for example, you're watching this or listening to this. This particular audio podcast, housingradio.com, that's where we do all of our other stuff with regard to real estate. This is an agent help broadcast that I'm doing today. Therefore, it's probably going to get listened to and traded around pretty good. And maybe if somebody's searching, you know, how not to be scammed as a real estate agent or whatever, it might pop up on page one or close to it, given time. With this isn't the only thing I would do, though. I would do this podcast. I would also upload this to YouTube in audio format. And then I would also take it and write an article about it, potentially also transcribing the content. And I would do that automatically or via a software engine, but at least, you know, still do it. So then I would have all of this verbiage having been, you know, put into this particular article. So that, again, what is that? Well, that's content, right? So that's how it's going to help me get to that first page of Google. But again, real estate's a crowded space, like insurance and lawyers and legal. Oh, my gosh, that's a crowded space. And what I mean is those spaces in the organic section of Google, they carry a premium. If you want a pay-per-click, and that's kind of how you judge an area, see how busy it is. If you want to get a pay-per-click campaign for people searching for squirrel taxidermy. Probably wouldn't be tough, and it'd probably be very cheap. I don't know how many people are searching for squirrel taxidermy. But again, if you're looking for used squirrel parts, or maybe you lost an eyeball, you need an arm, you need a leg, maybe there's a market for that. If you build websites around that, maybe build a blog, start writing about your squirrel taxidermy business, I would imagine if somebody's searching, they're going to find you page one organically without too much trouble. That space probably isn't very crowded. Same thing with neck and mole rats. I know there was a copy blogger lady that threw that out there, and again, that was nothing until she started talking about it, using that as an example. Again, not a very crowded space. Real estate? Oh my gosh. You have the real estate syndication websites, Zillow and Trulia. You have those out there. You have other large brokerages, Remax, Redfin, Coldwell Banker. These are all competing for space, Realtor.com and so on. They're all competing for that page one placement. They want to be there when people are searching for real estate, and not just nationally. They want to be there for people searching for real estate at a local level, because that's going to help their agents succeed. And potentially some of these websites, they're going to be selling, as you know, people's personal and private information to people willing to pay for it, such as us agents, right? Zillow, Trulia, they got the market cornered on that, and they're page one. Well, you're wondering, well, why are they then paying for ads? Because on page one, you can also see these major websites paying for ad space. Well, it shouldn't help, and it's not supposed to. But, you know, these companies are paying tens, hundreds of thousands of dollars, I would venture to say, to be in those spaces in the pay-per-click campaigns. I can't help but think that, you know, they might be loved a little bit more, maybe, when it comes to the organic results. But Google says that's not the case. But again, I don't know. They're saying it's not the case. We got to go with it because they're the biggest in the business, and that's where they are currently. But again, they're paying for ad space, so they're also you're seeing them twice. So the people that are visiting Google, they're seeing Zillow at the top, Zillow at the bottom. How do you do that? Pay-per-click campaigns, they can be anywhere from $3 per click and maybe less to a lot more, $19, $20 a click. And it depends on how busy that space is. Real estate, like I said, very expensive. Law firms, legal, insurance, very expensive. That pay-per-click stuff is way up there. Every time somebody clicks, that's going to be $19, $20. When they do click, where are they going? Well, so you say, you know what, Connor, I'm going to spend $1,000 a month on pay-per-click ads. Okay, well, where are you going to put it? Well, I'm going to go all in at Google. Oh, great. So you go there and somebody clicks on your link. Where are they going? Are they going to something interesting, or are they going to some place that's going to have them clicking off in a matter of seconds, not capturing their interest? Something to consider. So wherever you are advertising online, if you're paying for it, make sure those links are going to places that are of interest. Example, how about a video? How about maybe an audio recording if you can get them to click on a video? Everybody understands the YouTube format, so that makes sense to people. So when they see that, they're going to click. You know, that's going to be something that they're more than likely going to just automatically click on. Well, you have a few seconds to give your elevator speech and have them happy and want to maybe take that next step, which would be either registering to search or asking a question or giving up some piece of personal information so you can assist them in some way, shape, or form, either now or sometime in the future, as they designate. That's what you're looking for. That's now a real conversion, and potentially that was worth at least $20 for that click. But then you get a lot of looky-loos and a lot of other people. So be wary with that. There's really no way around the tire kicker. People are going to be looking, but in a lot of cases, they're going to be seeing these syndication sites kind of at the beginning, and then maybe they'll start doing longer searches, more inclusive searches, or maybe something more specific. When that happens, then potentially, if you're writing good content, and again, sharing is important, folks. Don't be a taker. Also be a sharer of other agents' content. I wouldn't do it in the same city. I'm not going to share anybody else's content here, but I would share somebody's content back east. Bill Gassett, for example, or Katrina, or these other people that I happen to follow that are big in the social media realm of real estate, I will share their stuff also. as they will mine. So it does work out. So let me give you the three things. The first thing, when they do call you or they do send you this email, and it does look absolutely interesting, and again, they're looking for a conversion too. Maybe it's via spam. Maybe they're just calling you because they're trying to, they're not doing it the legal way. Maybe you have your a phone number that they're calling on a do not call list, the federal do not call list or whatever it is. But anyway, they're calling, right? So you pick up the phone. Hey, it's Connor with Remax. How can I help you? They say, yes, I'm Mr. McIver. I'm just calling. Are you still representing buyers and sellers here in Santa Clara? They say, oh, yes, I am. They say, hey, we have an ad. We have space opened up. And are you able to handle more buyers and more sellers? Well, of course. Who's going to say no, completely full up, so busy, can't stand it. So you say, sure, absolutely, I can. We say, you know what, we have this thing. So now, before he gets too deep, reach out and say, listen, just so I know, you were real quick at the beginning, and they will be. They're going to be super fast. Give me your name, company name. What's your name? Okay, my name's Bob. Okay, great, Bob. Bob what? Bob Smith, great. Now, Bob, what's your company name? And he gives it to you, Angen or, you know, G Moly or whatever it is. And then also after you get that company name, get their address. And real quick, Google Maps, map the address. Is this a one-bedroom apartment or a studio, you know, in somewhere? Or is this a real brick-and-mortar, real live, you know, people accountable business? What is this? Now, I'm not trying to slam the guy in the studio that's trying to make some money, and maybe does a fantastic job and does everything he promises he'll do and backs up everything in writing, hoorah, good for him. And maybe he is your best bet. But if they're trying to portray themselves as something as they're not, something that they're not, maybe of concern to some people. So I would ask that. I'd Google it and find out. And then, you know, confront him on each thing. And if he has justification as to why they don't need to be brick and mortar, they can be virtual or in the cloud or whatever it is, then, you know, you buy it or you don't buy it. Next thing I would look at, number two, if they're offering you something new, the new thing, like not new, but there are these follow me ads. You've seen them. You go in there and you search, or even at home. You have Alexa, you have Echo, you have one of those items, maybe the Google one or the others that are out there. And you're talking to your family about toilet paper. Maybe you ask the device itself. Then all of a sudden, you see ads for toilet paper popping up all over the place around you. These are follow ads. That's something that the systems out there, people can actually create ads in that space. So when somebody does a search for houses or real estate, wherever they go back to their Facebook. As long as they still have that same browser connection, those cookies enabled, they're going to start seeing your stuff pop up over in the right-hand margin in the ads. Same thing on the other social media sites. So it's going to follow them. If they go to another site, maybe they're interested in what the Kardashians did this week, and they look at those ads at the bottom, they're going to run into the ad maybe midstream or somewhere as they're reading this particular article. Again, these are places where you pay for that kind of placement. But you want proof of that. And you're going to want whatever they're telling you with regard to these follow me things or anything new, any of this Web 2.0 crap that people are trying to sell, you're going to want to get that in writing. This shouldn't be, hey, let me give you a credit card, $49.99 a month. We're going to waive the startup fee of $1 billion today, and we're going to get it. This getting in this space shouldn't be quick. Then even if it's $50 a month, you should at least get some kind of verification. And see, they're into the numbers, right? They want to call the 50 top agents on Google and do those deals in a day because that's how they make their money. Well, if it's worth it, more than likely, they're not going to be reaching out to you over the phone. You're going to be finding them somewhere or getting that referral or seeing them online. But again, not in all cases. Sometimes good deals do call you on the phone. But again, you want to get it in writing. Number third, placement. They're going to talk about organic. They're going to talk page one. They're going to give you all this whiz-bang stuff, and it's going to really excite you because you've seen, you know, Zillow and Trulia and these other syndication sites, being page one, realtor.com and all, which is our lobby. But again, here we are at page one. You're going to want to ask for, and this is, you know, when they're talking a bit to you about placement, they're going to say, well, we're going to get you page one. Oh, you're going to give me page one for what keyword or what keyword phrase? And then they're going to pause a little bit, as this cat did the other day. Said, well, I need you to talk to my technical guy, because it's really not, I really don't know exactly the inner workings, but all I do is make the contact, and if somebody's interested, I pass them along. Hoorah, great. Here's the thing. Sorry about that little cough. Here's the thing. I'll give you an example. Local market, Santa Clarita Real Estate. Tough. That keyword is tough to score for. That's number one. Number one keyword out here. And if you do that search, it's going to depend on the device and your search history as to what results come up. The pay-per-click are going to be very expensive in that realm. Could be, you know, $5 depending on the time of day, depending on the device, depending on how they have the ad set up. Could be $20, $25, $30 per click. Now, don't fret if you're an agent thinking, God, I don't know if I want to get a pay-per-click. I know all my competitors are going to go click on me and cost me a lot of money. Well, once they click on you from a particular device, it's not going to charge you the next time. So as soon as you get through everybody, then you're not going to have to sweat it. But at this particular case in his pitch, I asked him what keywords or keyword phrases. It's going to be difficult to get on that page one organic unless it's a really long tail keyword search phrase. Gated homes in Santa Clarita within the Valencia Summit is an example of a very long keyword phrase. That one, a couple articles, a couple links, you might be able to get page one, but how many people are searching for that? Not very many, but the ones that are, they're serious. I'm Connor McIver. I hope this gave some guidance to my fellow agents, because I'll tell you, there's a lot of scams out there, and I know you see it, and you've gotten the calls, and it was just time, I think, I put something like this together. It gets much deeper. There's a lot more information to convey. I've eaten up 20 minutes of your time. I hope you enjoyed it. Please share with your friends, even in other businesses. It's not the case that it doesn't exist, and it's still there. People are calling local businesses because they have access to it. All they do is Google, and then they pick up the phone, and they call. And they do a lot of that, and there's a lot of businesses that are also getting scammed out there as well. I'm Connor McIver. Please share. Hopefully this will help you. Be safe, and if you're looking for me online, you can easily find me on Facebook, facebook.com/Paris911 fans. Thanks. Talk to you soon. Bye.